Steve Dangle's a new dad. And when you're a new dad, you don't get a lot of sleep. And when you don't get a lot of sleep, you forget to do the ad read off the top of your trade video.
Yes, Jesse, and I appreciate that very much. Continue.
And that's why we've partnered with Sleep Breakthrough, a natural formula that helps you fall asleep very quickly so that you don't forget to do your ad read.
It's true. This sounds like a product I need very much. Tell me more.
Sleep Breakthrough is a natural formula that produces the precursors to melatonin. So it's better than melatonin because it creates the natural things in your body to then produce melatonin to then help you fall asleep very quickly and get all of the sleep you need to go about the rest of your day.
And apparently it also comes with the help of supportive friends.
If you're struggling with sleep like Steve Dangle, who cannot fall asleep quickly enough and get enough sleep, I highly recommend Sleep Breakthrough. Visit biooptimizers.com/dangle and use promo code dangle for 10% off your purchase of Sleep Breakthrough. It'll help you fall asleep super quickly. It's all natural. That's biooptimizers.com/dangle. Promo code dangle, 10% off your purchase.
Biooptimizers.com/dangle, promo code dangle, 10% off. I am getting some immediately. Hey, guess what? Cade Webber is a Leaf! Or at very least, he will be if they sign him by August 15th, because that is the deadline that they have to sign him, because they just traded for his rights. The Toronto Maple Leafs have traded a 2026 sixth rounder to the Carolina Hurricanes for Cade Webber, a defenseman who the Hurricanes drafted in the fourth round in 2019. I thought this tweet from Mike Stevens was very funny. Guess how tall this dude is? I'll give you a hint, he's not short. 6'6". He just turned 23 years old in January. He's actually listed under 200 pounds on eliteprospects.com. 6'6", under 200 pounds. Steak for breakfast, young man. Don't look at me. That's exactly what the Leafs organization is probably going to tell him to do. I've seen some sites say 6'7". I mean, with any player in the NHL, you just got to give a grace of like an inch or two. Which, now that I say it out loud and into a camera, is kind of a funny clip. So how did this come to be? How did Cade Webber get drafted in the fourth round in 2019? Well, he was big. He played with the Rivers School in USHS Prep, and he was nearly a point-a-game defenseman with 12 goals. The season after, he went to the Penticton Vs of the BCHL, which, if you don't know, is Junior A. It's one of the better Junior A leagues out there. It's been in the news recently because it's trying to do its own thing. And his offense dried up significantly, just 5 points in 23 games, just 2 goals. Then, obviously, COVID happened. Screw COVID, it ruins everything. Since then, he has played 115 games over the last 4 seasons for Boston University, an incredibly good program, but remember that time he said 115 games, 16 points in those games. So the reason we keep bringing up his height is it's relevant. There's a reason why Brad Treliving and his management staff wanted this guy. He's huge. It certainly wasn't for his offensive ability. Who knows, maybe there's a little bit more there than he was letting on. This is a program that has Lane Hudson in it. After all, Boston University does not have trouble generating offense. But he's huge. He's already an adult. He's 23 years old. If they sign him to a contract, which I imagine they're going to do in short order, he goes to the Marlies after Boston University season is done. There's the potential of him being called up. I don't know. I think this is more of a system move. But a sixth round pick is actually a decent price to pay for a prospect that you believe could play professional games for your organization, maybe even with your big club. And there's years already down the line in his development. What are the odds that a sixth rounder is going to make the NHL? They're probably, worst case, about as good as Cade Webber's chances are. He's also the assistant captain of Boston University, so like, you know, character and leadership and all that. It's extra relevant when you consider that Boston University already has 12 NHL draft prospects on it, not including Cade Webber. They're a really good program. In fact, one of the players on their roster who's not already an NHL prospect is their top scorer, Macklin Celebrini, who's very likely going to go first overall in the 2024 draft. Here's a review from someone who's actually seen him. Colby Cohen, former NHL player. I've watched Cade Webber play about 100 games at BU. He's a 6'7", there's that discrepancy again, a 6'7", physical shot-blocking machine who skates well and can make a first pass. This is a well-developed prospect and is 100% worth a sixth-round pick by the Leafs. That's just the eye test saying, oh, he blocked shots, but you don't know if that's 100% true. Here are the numbers from Kyle Cushman. Cade Webber is a 6'7", there it is again, 216 pounds. I'm gonna put the tweet next to me just so you can watch me read it. Cade Webber is 6'7", 216 pounds per BU's site. So, wow, he has put on weight compared to the number that Elite Prospects has. That's like a difference of, what is that, 20 pounds? Okay, so he's big. He would already be one of the heaviest and tallest players on the roster. A near zero offensively, but leads the Terriers with 107 blocks. Next closest is his D partner with 66. He's in his final NCAA season and needs to be signed before August 15th. Expect him to join the Marlies when BU's run is over. It's a smart move for Carolina too. I mean, they drafted a player they obviously liked, otherwise they wouldn't have used a fourth round pick on him. COVID sort of screwed some things up. That doesn't necessarily mean he fell out of favor with the Hurricanes. It just means they talked to the kid. They weren't going to be able to sign him. Trade deadline's tomorrow. They called up Brad Treliving and said, hey, how about you give us that person? Brad said, is he big? And they said, shut up, you have his Elite Prospects page open right now. Brad said, yes, I do. Carolina said, well, he's actually 20 pounds heavier than that. And Brad said, shut up and make that trade call. Interesting little move. Now, things are slowly taking shape, well, quickly taking shape with the Leafs' D core. They got Labushkin, big snot. They got Joel Edmondson, big snot. Timothy Liljegren might be coming out of the lineup pretty soon. Big-ish, zero snot. No snot. The, like, just no snot. Napkin. I didn't know what to say there. What's the absence of snot? Dry nostril player. So the Leafs trade another pick. They're sort of running out of picks. A player who they might deal at this deadline, I'm starting to feel it happening, could be Timothy Liljegren. I've recruited Mike Stevens, who's been a guest on the Steve Dangle podcast in the past. He's written basically everywhere, most recently with the Associated Press. Here he is to talk about Timothy Liljegren, his relationship with the Leafs as a organization, and he's going to expand on some things like Sean Walker and Tyler Toffoli, who has not been dealt yet.
One name to monitor when it comes to the Leafs in the lead up to the deadline, and it might not be imminent right now, is Timothy Liljegren. Now, when Brad Treliving took over this team in the summer, he surveyed the roster and Liljegren was identified as a player that doesn't necessarily play his type of hockey. And if you look at the acquisitions of the Joel Edmondsons and the Ilya Labushkins, they're almost diametrically opposed players to Timothy Liljegren in that they're big, they you know, don't move the puck as well as Liljegren does, and they're more physical and sort of disrupting the rush type players. And Liljegren's stock has fallen within the organization. You can just see it from the outside, and also from indications that I've got is that, you know, he was a scratch during the playoffs at times last year, and also he was called out publicly by his coach. The possibility could be that he is included in a bigger package to get that top four right shot defenseman that they need, or potentially, again, package someone else to get a 2020 or to get a first round pick that could replace the 2021 first or 2024 first that they could potentially move out for that top right defenseman. However, that's been a sticking point in a lot of things, namely in Sean Walker. The Leafs were in on Sean Walker. They've been monitoring him basically since the start of training camp. However, the Flyers have stood firm when it comes to his price, which being a first-round pick, and they eventually got that from the Colorado Avalanche, obviously having to take on a bigger contract. But, you know, that they had this cap space to do that. Now, up front with the Leafs, they are one of the teams that are in on Tyler Toffoli. Toffoli is the belle of the ball here. He has 26 goals. He's in 61 games. He's a veteran guy. He's won before. He's a proven playoff performer. The price is extremely high on him from the Devils if they decide to actually sell him. And what a lot of teams are doing and viewing Tyler Toffoli as is Jake Guentzel insurance, because Jake Guentzel is the top forward on the market right now, and the price is extremely high from Kyle Dubas, and if they feel that they got priced out of Jake Guentzel, they will now turn their sights to Tyler Toffoli. Now, it's being reported and also indicated to me that the Vegas Golden Knights are obviously monitoring it just in case they get priced out of Guentzel. The Vancouver Canucks are another team that is looking at. They could have a reunion. They're interested in Tyler Toffoli if they lose out on Guentzel. And the LA Kings are a team that have expressed interest in a reunion with Toffoli. And if you even look at their moves, they play some guys on waivers today to open up some cap space. There are a lot of moving parts. Prices can change based on the market. However, it does seem like teams are viewing this as if they don't get Guentzel, they turn it to Toffoli, and the Leafs are one of those teams in on Toffoli.
All very spicy and all stuff that we're going to be keeping an eye on. very hard for tomorrow's trade deadline. I wonder if by less than 24 hours from now, Timothy Liljegren is still with the Leafs. For now, that is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you liked this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. But God gosh darn it, go to SDPN and click subscribe there, because I'm going to make a video for that channel right now. Tell all your friends. He's 6'6". At least. He might be bigger. We don't. The internet.